Let me take you to a super religious school teacher who decided it was a good idea to call her student the N-word because her student said, "Oh my God." And she was so offended because it obviously must have offended Jesus. So she says the N-word to the student. I kid you not. Let's put up a picture of the school. This happened in Arlington, Texas, all right? An Arlington elementary school has fired a substitute teacher after other teachers say he used the N-word in front of elementary school students. Let me give you some background as to why. This is according to Fox 4 News. One mother who did not want Fox 4 to use her name says her son told her after school on Friday. She says the child was not in the classroom during the interaction, but relayed to her what his friends who were there witnessed. Fox 4 spoke with the Swift elementary school teacher off camera, who also did not want her name used. She says she happened to be in the hallway Friday afternoon when she noticed a commotion from a nearby classroom. There's more. Here's how the interaction with the substitute went. One of the kids in the class blurted out, "Oh my God." And he replied, "Don't say that." And they were like, "Why can't we say, oh my God?" And he said, "That's using Jesus's name in vain," the mom said. Continued the report. They also told Fox 4, that's when the substitute teacher told the kids, "It would be like me saying the N-word." The teacher who stepped in to intervene says after hearing from the students, she approached the substitute, who she says then added, "Yes, I said the N-word. And I say it again." Okay. All right. There's more. Arlington Independent School District says the teacher was also working again at Swift Elementary on Monday. The district says it received a complaint from a parent via email Monday and opened an investigation, which eventually led to the termination. The identity of the employee has not been released to the public, and it should be. In recent years, Texas schools have seen a number of racial controversies. Last October, a theater arts teacher at a school in Houston resigned after complaining there was no White History Month and that he can't use the N-word. And this January, a school board member for Cypress Fairbanks Independent School District suggested that dropout rates in Houston are linked to a number of black teachers they have on staff. And the list goes on and on. Texas legislature passed a bill that would basically make it illegal for a school teacher to tell you that the KKK is morally wrong. They can no longer give what's called deference in the teaching when teaching about elements like the KKK in their historical context. All right, interesting but real. Students being bullied by teachers. Racial bullying is a reality. When they did the big anti-bullying campaign, remember that? You know, it was a big thing. Dr. Phil was behind it. He had a lot of national people. They did tours. Well, some advocacy groups said, "Hey, listen, we need to include racial bullying because we are seeing the stats and we need to connect the two." And the individuals who are all about no bullying said, "Oh, no, 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 no. That's making it way too political." And so they decided not to. They decided not to include what the data said they needed to include, which was to fight against racial bullying, to create policies to lessen or eliminate racial bullying. And so now we have it happening, not just from the students, but from the teachers. All right, Dina Dahl, thoughts here.
This is an elementary school, so these kids are really young. And I hope in that instance, they had somebody come in and explain to the students why that's not okay, because otherwise all those other kids hearing that and watching that are going to think this is acceptable. And you know, that's why it's so important. Teachers, we've talked about this before, they have these students kind of captive and they are modeling for these children. And it seems like in Texas, for some reason, they seem to be having a kind of a race to the bottom against Florida here in terms of human rights and human dignity. And you know, I personally think they have to get their act together there.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, we're gonna follow this. I want to know who the substitute teacher was. All right, so we're going to follow this story and give you an update.